Hello and welcome to another modelling video. This is Alan from the Makana Man at YouTube with another modelling video. Today we shall be building the Helia AMX 13105. It is a post Second World War French tank. Now, unfortunately, it doesn't have a cool, catchy nickname like a Sherman or other famous tanks throughout history. The name's a bit lame. But it is a very interestingly profiled tank. The chassis itself does remind me of very panzerish, though the top turret and the massive gun is very unique to this design. Let's have a look at the build. Now, Helia is a well-known brand. They make pretty quality models, and this is my first time building one. The box, straight off the bat, impresses the hell out of me. It's one of those lift types that you see in premium resin kits. All the information around, paint chip colours, size, everything you want to know. Cracking it open to look in the inside, we're given little hints and tutorials on how to do water slide decals and attaching tracks in all a manner of languages. Again, very impressive. The instruction sheets, very clear, very large, again, multiple languages, and a very nice decal layout. Further, cannot complain. Wish I could see this in other budget kit layouts. We get three runners. The fact that it's got raised detail, and by the looks of the proportions, this looks like to be either a repressing of a vintage kit or an old mould, or an old mould being bought out or re-released. We get a small bit of vinyl tracks and a very interesting, lovely decal set. Now, unfortunately, I lost these decals. No idea where the hell they went off to, which is a shame, but I did made do. Bit unusual for me. We started straight off with the chassis and put the base together. The wheel attachment and alignment was very unusual. You sort of had this round ball nub and cup intersection in the wheel which glued in. Kind of tricky to make all the wheels perfectly straight, but the wheel assembly itself and the tracks were done very quickly in record time. The following rest of the construction of the model, I did not encounter any problems. Small seam at the front and rear, and everything just virtually, especially the turret, snapped all into place. Bit rough looking, but with a little sanding and neatening up, a very, very nice and convincing finish. Assembling a lot of vintaged armor, I gotta say that this came together very, very well, and I have absolutely no complaints in the construction. Unfortunately, the proportions, and looking at the box art, looking at reference material, is grossly out of proportion, not accurate whatsoever. Nonetheless, it's fairly unique in shape, cheap enough in price, and definitely enjoy it from this stage. Sitting on top of this model for a few months snapped together, the building process only literally taking hours, the front of the gun barrel was drilled out, and the entire model was primed using Gaia Note Surfacer rust colour, which is traditionally a tank undercoat colour, very popular. Expect a review and tutorial of that fairly shortly. In my efforts of practicing airbrushing, even on the smallest of models, I appreciated everything in lacquer black and base coated Tamiya sand yellow acrylic. Once all done and dried, a tad of post shading in some areas to create shadows, a bit of definition. Details such as flaps, wheel rubbers, tracks, tools, other bits and pieces were hand painted with various different acrylics and a fine paintbrush. Then, to catch all the raised and recessed detail, a sludge wash of Citadel acrylic black. Let the piece to dry. Top coat of Tamir clear matte. And mucked around a bit with pigments from MIG and the pigment setter. Due to the fact that I stupidly lost the decals, I had a little look at some reference material, and this tank came in your standard NATO green or desert yellow. And the fact that a lot of these tanks were sold to Central Europe, Middle Eastern countries, and later on Southeast Asian countries, I really wanted to go for a Middle East look. I believe some of these are even to this day operational around Lebanon. So absolutely no markings. Basic setup. This is the brought back non-modernized version of the tank. And attempted to do a little aged weathering in the form of spot rust and build up of sand and wear. I still haven't 100% mastered and conquered the use of MIG production pigments, though always looking for a chance to have a go. This kit may appear to be overweathered, but, and I would most certainly agree if entered in the competition, but as something that just sits on the shelf and rocks out with the rest of my 72nd 76 20mm collection, can't be more happy. I think it looks fairly cool, not too authentic, so not too worried about the authenticity of the weathering. Kind of a bit comic bookish, actually. All in all, that completely concludes this build. I will buy more Helier kits if I do come across them. I also highly recommend the purchase of this particular model if you are fancy enough. I had enough fun that if you're a 72nd builder, it's something to look out for. And if I do buy more, I'll most definitely review it and play it back here. Thank you very much for watching, and as always, until next time, stay tuned to more videos of armor, Gundam modeling, and tutorials, product reviews. Of course, don't forget, and I don't plug this often enough, I've got a Facebook page for the Makoto Man. A lot of these builds I do sometimes have been done ages ago, and content on that is very recent to what I'm working on immediately and not what's released in video. Catch you later.